people love science fiction movies. And at the same time, there's also, it seems like, zillions of stars in the sky. There's so many stars out there, so many possibilities. So, do you ever wonder whether aliens exist? Well, the thing is, I'm an astrophysicist, and I wonder whether aliens exist. In fact, I've been wondering about it my entire life. So over the last 10 years or so, I've made it one of my fields of study, what's called astrobiology, which is the study of life in the universe. So this question of life elsewhere, aliens, is one that's very old. 2,500 years ago, you can see the Greeks yelling at each other about it. But the thing about all of those arguments over all those millennia, it's just been opinions. And the thing that's different now is we finally have the technologies to actually go look for aliens, to go look for life in the universe. And where should we look? If you were interested in finding Nebraskans, would you go look in a small village in the Himalayas? No, you'd go to Nebraska, because that's where Nebraskans live. And in the same way, we shouldn't be looking for aliens here on Earth. We should be looking where aliens live, which are alien planets, or what we call exoplanets. For the 2,500 years that we've been asking about alien life, we've also been asking whether there were any planets orbiting other stars. And now we know that using these amazing telescopes that we've built, that every star in the sky hosts a family of worlds. One in five stars in the sky will have a planet orbiting the star in the right place for life to form. And what that means is that that planet is orbiting not so close that any kind of water on the surface boils away, and not so far that it all freezes. We know these planets are habitable, but we now have the ability to find out whether those planets are inhabited by life. If a planet is inhabited, if it has life, then it's probably going to need an atmosphere. If there's abundant life on that planet, then the atmosphere will contain traces of that life. It'll contain signatures of that life. And what is remarkable right now is we have developed techniques we call atmospheric characterization, where we can actually see into the atmospheres of planets that are 40 light years away, 80 light years away, 120 light years away. And we can see what we call the spectral fingerprints of these chemicals that would come from life. Now, you know, you may be like, oh great, microbes. I don't want to find microbes. I want to find like intelligent aliens, intelligent civilizations. Well, we got you covered there too. I am the principal investigator of NASA's first grant ever to study atmospheric technosignatures, right? The signature not of just a biosphere, not just of plants and microbes, but of actually technology. And so really that's what we call it, a technosphere. So on the one hand, you got biosignatures. On the other hand, you got technosignatures. We know what we should be looking for, or at least we're, you know, in the process of figuring out what we should be looking for. We know how to look for it. And now the real question is developing the telescope technologies to be able to actually go do it. So there's the James Webb Space Telescopes, which I'm sure many of you have heard, which is orbiting out there right now. And it is at the hairy edge. It can just barely, if we get lucky, we might be able to detect a bio or techno signature. But the next few generations of telescopes that are coming up, so on the ground, people are building 30 meter telescopes. This is a telescope with a mirror that is the size of a football field. So those are coming around maybe in the next 5-10 years. We're gonna be able to really do searches for life, alien life, with those telescopes. And then NASA is planning the replacement for the JWST will be something called the Habitable Worlds Observatory, whose job is to search for habitable worlds, life in the universe. So that's why I like to say that in the next 10, 20, 30, 40 years, we will have actual data to this question that you're wondering about, but it's going to help us understand whether or not life is common or whether it's rare. So, you know, many people are interested in whether or not life is visiting Earth, alien life is visiting Earth, and that gets us to the subject of UFOs, unidentified flying objects, and what they're now being called UAPs, unidentified aerial phenomena. You know, I'm completely open to a open, transparent scientific investigation of UFOs and UAPs. But as of right now, from a scientist's perspective, there is nothing in that data which even comes close to the standards of evidence that we need to be able to, as scientists, to be able to make a firm conclusion. In fact, most of those sightings, well over 96% of those sightings, can be explained via other things, everything from balloons to airplanes. So there's really only about 4% of those sightings which still elude explanation. They should be investigated, but at this point, there's nothing there that really points to aliens are visiting us. So one of the things that I think is mistaken about thinking about alien life and our search for alien life is that we're gonna do it so we can make contact with them. But that's really not gonna happen. Like, let's imagine that we found alien life, even like examples of a technological civilization that was 100 light years away, right? What are we gonna do? We're gonna send them a message. Okay, we're gonna be like, yo, what's up? And then that message is gonna take 100 years to get there, and they're gonna get it, and then hopefully they'll respond, and they'll send it back. And so 200 years later, we get like, hey, nice to meet you. So it's like, you know, we're not gonna be able to have a conversation that is going to be meaningful for us because it's gonna take 200 years for the back and forth to happen. So I think we have to rethink kind of what is gonna happen when we discover alien life. In particular, what we're gonna do is we're gonna be able to watch them. We're gonna be able to watch this alien civilization going about its civilization business. It's gonna tell us huge things. But the idea that we're actually gonna have a conversation with them, yeah, I think that's one of the things that we sort of need to get out of our heads, that the point of this whole process is to get in touch with them. So many people often ask me, do I believe whether aliens are out there, alien life is out there? As a scientist, you know, I'm not into belief. I don't wanna believe, I wanna know. That's why I went into science. But you know, my intuition, my belief, my prejudice, my bias, is that, you know, the universe is big and the universe is old, and that we are not the first time in the history of the universe that that life has formed or that intelligent life has formed. I think it's possible that microbial life is quite common, that often, you know, if any world that has the right ingredients, that will form. But that intelligent life might be quite rare. It's possible that intelligent life doesn't form very often, or it doesn't last very long. If every civilization lasts 100,000 years, which would be a lot longer, you know, than we've lasted in terms of being a technological civilization, and then goes extinct, then the universe right now could be pretty empty. We could be one of the few technological civilizations that are out there right now, just because the timescale is so short relative to the age of the galaxy that the galaxy would be pretty sterile at any particular time. But you know, all of this is just conjecture. There's only one way to find out, and that's to go look.